Good morning, everyone. This is your pal, Nick Kick, 2001 here, home of the Further 2 and No Time to Die content. Speaking of No Time to Die, I will rewatch No Time to Die today. Today, and I will rewatch Frozen 2 tonight, like Frozen 2 Fantastic Four on Instagram. So I just wanted to do that for a special occasion because today is Frozen 2 Fantastic Four birthday. Woo-woo! Happy birthday, buddy. I want to wish you a happy birthday. And I will watch Hotel Transylvania 4, but not today, because I don't want to hear about Ouija gaming and say, oh, come on, the movie's masterpiece. Go watch it. What is your thought? Yeah. Yeah, I'm not going to say Hotel Transylvania 4 is a masterpiece. But you know what? I'm just going to wait until Frozen 2 Fantastic Four watched it. And second, I don't have an Amazon Prime Video subscription, so I really do not know how I'm gonna get an Amazon Prime Video. I really hope Hotel Transylvania 4 will be on DVD and I can make a destruction in the video in the future. And so yeah, guys, so let's get to the Rated R movie. Oh boy, we all love Rated R movie, like language, violent, sex scene, sexual content, drug use, etc. too. But the one Rated R movie I'm not gonna watch is The Green Inferno. Let's not talk about it, and I am definitely not gonna show a picture of it. It's pretty disturbing. Don't let you guys watch it. And that's why I'm doing my top 10 best Rated R movie of all time. Well, originally I start on the worst list, but I'm not gonna start the worst list because today is a happy day, and I'm just gonna try my best to be a happy day. Because every time I talk about the worst movie, I have a freaking attitude today. And so, you guys, so today I'm doing my top 10 best Rated R movie of all time. These other Rated R movies are so brutal, so languaging, and so amazing too, and such an amazing masterpiece, and won at the Oscar for Best Pictures. Or some movie, because I don't know. And so, you guys, before I get started, I have some honor to mention. The movie was so great, and it didn't quite make a list. Ted, Kingsman, The Secret Service, 1917, The Matrix, American Beauty, The Shining, Die Hard, It Chapter 1 and 2, 21 Jump Street, and last not least, South Park, Bigger, Longer, and Uncut. Were not included with. Oh yeah, I forgot. Uncut Gem would be my honor to mention, so I can't forget that one Adam Sandler on the list. And so, yeah. Enough's enough talking. Get your Rated R movie DVD, get your Rated R t-shirt on, and now it's time to talk about the best Rated R movie I have ever seen. Let's get started, shall we? So I got my spit in it. Alright guys, coming in number 10 is The Searching List. I really love this movie. This movie is such a beautiful, amazing masterpiece. And Steven Spielberg's direction of this movie are really awesome too. So that's why The Searching List is in my number 10. I will rewatch that movie on the anniversary in the future. And so yeah, now that's why The Searching List is in my number 10. Let's get to number 9. Hey, go, give me that, no, give me that, come on, number 9, it's that, because of you. Sorry about that, I'm just doing my Sandy Fico, give me to you. I don't know what the Riddick is, but the Riddick is how bad it was, so, don't you guys watch it. And so, yeah, coming in number 9 is the Deadpool 1 and 2. We just want to put Deadpool 1 and 2, except the Silver movie, because I was originally going to put just Deadpool, but Frozen was angry, so I had to fix it again, and I actually put Ted on number 4, he was angry again, and I had to make it. Thanks a lot, Redbox, you waste my time for your horse stuff. I hate you. And anyway, guys, let's talk about Deadpool 1. The Deadpool 1 is one of the greatest comic book movie of 2016, because this movie is such an awesome, amazing mess. Oh, you know what, squash that. Probably this movie is in my second favorite comic book movie of 2016. My number one is Captain America Civil War, so can't forget. we can't forget about that. And so, yeah, this movie has some amazing humor, amazing action, some brutal action, too. My favorite action scene of this movie has to be the opening of the film when the music is just like the same thing for Deadpool. And I think Peter Griffin as Deadpool, that parody skit, the made in Family Guy, oh man, that is so funny. I actually wet my butt off in that Family Guy scene. And so yeah, Deadpool 1 is such an awesome, amazing masterpiece. So yeah, let's get to Deadpool 2. And I can respect Harry Thomas' opinion on that movie, but I think Deadpool 2 is one of my favorite Deadpool movie I ever seen. And so yeah, and that's why Deadpool 1 and 2 is in my number 9. Let's get to number 8. We got the 80s show. I really don't know what the word it is, but just deal with it. And so, you guys, coming to number 8 is A Star Was Born. Added up one of the most beautiful live action, the motion picture movie I ever seen in 2018. And so, yeah, and Lady Gaga and Bradley Cooper has some cute chemistry, and the villain of this movie are really awesome, too. Yes, yes, yeah, the villain of this movie are really awesome, too. And my favorite song of this movie is has to be The Shallow song. Well, The Shallow was a performer at the Oscars, and so Oscar gave Lady Gaga some Oscars. Good job, Lady Gaga, good job. Well, originally, I don't like Lady Gaga, and thank God Lady Gaga made me like that song. Thank good, good job, girl. Good job. Anita, we, good job, girl. Great job. And I'm never gonna watch that, The House of Gucci. You ever not watch that PT shit. And so, yeah, and that's why A Star Was Born is my number 8. And this is the only Lady Gaga movie I seen. I haven't seen, The House of Gucci, but I'm not gonna watch that PT shit. And so, yeah, let's get to number 7. Alright, guys, start your engine, and get ready to ride on the world. And the ride on the number 7 spot is Baby Driver. Oh, man, this movie is one of the best rated R movie of 2017. Man, I really love this movie. I really missed this movie to see it in theaters, and thank God. This movie was ill on FX, and I watched this movie on FX. I watched a few part of it, and I watched all of them. Yeah. I watched all of them. It was such an awesome, amazing masterpiece. And I would do this Toon Style in the future, because that Toon Style I made, it was really garbage. Like, seriously, the Artemis fell dead as a villain. Stupid. And so, yeah, guys, Kevin Spacey is a really awesome character. Jamie Foxx, he's a really awesome character. And that character played by Cinderella, and that Cinderella 2015, which honestly, I'm not a huge fan of that movie. That movie's the most overrated movie of 2015. Yep, at least she's redeemed herself. But the one character I really like the most, it had to be the main character. The main character didn't say nothing. He just wanted to take himself away to Cersei. And this is how you make a great action movie. And so, you guys, and that's why Baby Driver is him at number 7. Let's get to number 6. Alright, hey kid. If you like Wolverine, I really enjoy you like Wolverine. But don't watch this movie, because this movie is too brutal for a kid's movie. Don't watch kids watch it again. And so, you guys, coming in number 6 is Logan. Added up one of the best Wolverine movie I ever seen. This movie's way better than the 2013 version. And so, you guys, this movie is such an awesome, amazing masterpiece. The villain, and the story, the action, the production, and the quality of the film are really beautiful, too. And Patrick Stewart, he redeemed himself, to that awful atrocity, which is the Moji movie as a talking poop. That is really stupid, and I don't want to talk about that piece of shit. And so, you guys, and that's why Logan is in my number 6. And I won't spoil the Logan death scene in that movie, too. And so, yeah, let's get to number 5, because these are the type of movie I really love the most. So, you guys, it'd be like war movie, but guys, don't watch this movie, because this movie is one of the most brutal war movie I ever seen, because this movie is too bloody for kids. And so, you guys, coming to number 5 is Saving Private Ryan. Added up one of my third favorite Tom Hanks movie I ever seen, because this movie is such an awesome, brilliant masterpiece, and Steve Zissou had to make a great war movie. And that guy who played by Michael from The Good Place, yes, folks, he's in that movie. I was shocked and speechless. I was like, wait a minute, is that Michael from The Good Place? Wow. Well, I did not know he's in that 90s movies. Man, lucky you, man. Lucky you. And Tom Hanks. So I gotta say for Tom Hanks, would not let his down. Because I haven't seen Inferno starting Tom Hanks. I'm not watching that piece of shit. And sorry, guys, and that's why Saving Private Ryan is in my number 5. Let's get to number 4, and I'm very sorry because my power just turned off, which is stupid. You know what, let's get it real quick. Let's get to number 4. Alright, guys, coming to number 4 is Joker. Added up one of the greatest darker comic book movie I've ever seen in my lifetime, next to The Dark Knight. Because this movie is such an awesome, brilliant masterpiece. Joker Phoenix as Joker is one of the best Joker Phoenix performances I've ever seen. And Marvin Dino, he redeemed himself to that awful Dirty Grandpa. Yeah, Dirty Grandpa's in my number 10 worst rated R movie of all time. Yeah, I cannot believe why he's in that comedy movie. Stupid. Totally disrespectful to his career. And thank God, Robert De Niro, and I can respect Grace Runner's opinion, because Grace Runner did not like Robert De Niro as Murray Franklin, but I have no problem with him, because it's true. And so, yeah, and this movie is one of the most controversial movies of 2019. Because when this movie came out at the film festival, a lot of people say this movie dangerous, this movie disturbing, and this movie too brutal, and a lot of too. And it got a stupid government and Billy Tilly talk about this movie. And this movie was in the news podcast. And my thought on it, that is really stupid. This has got to be one of the worst controversial things I ever experienced in my lifetime. And thank God Frozen 2 didn't get controversial. Thank God. And so, you guys, saying Cutie controversial is 100 times better than Joker controversial. Because Joker controversial is one of the worst things of 2019. It's even worse that people storm Area 51, which is unnecessary. You can't storm Area 51, you freaking dingbag. And so, yeah, let's get to number 3. Because every time I talk about the controversial, it makes me want to... Oh my god, it makes me want to bang my head in the table. So, hey guys, coming in number 3 is the Suicide Squad. I just do not get the hate about this movie. This movie is such an awesome movie, Suicide Squad. And now this is how you make a great Suicide Squad movie. The Harley Quinn of this movie is way better than the 2016. Because the 2016 Harley Quinn was being a stripper. That's not her character, you freaking damn bad. And Bloodsport, I really love Bloodsport. And Bloodsport, this has got to be one of the best, one of the best performances I've ever seen for this guy, because Edgerosa, yeah, this has got to be one of the best Edgerosa performances I've ever seen. He redeemed himself to that awful as a villain from the Star Trek Beyond. I really love the Star Trek Beyond, but I do not like him in that movie, because his voice in that movie was really annoying. So yeah, and Peachmaker added out one of the best John Cena character, way better than he was in Playing with Fire. Yeah, F that movie. And Rick Flag is all I gotta say, Rick Flag. And Ratcatcher, hey, Ratcatcher 2 fan, I know that's your favorite character, but I still have some feel negative about you. But Ratcatcher, she was such a beautiful, really looking woman. And King Shark added out one of the best characters of the movie, because the best character of this movie is King Shark. A lot of people agree that King Shark is one of the best characters, because King Shark is like the DC version of Groot, really Warner Brothers ripping off MCU. You know what, let's get to number 2. And Screw and Sapphin has one opinion of this movie, because his opinion of this movie really sucks. And I will do a commentary on Sapphin has one, the Suicide Squad went in the future. I gotta do No Time to Die first. So yeah, I will do a commentary on his Suicide Squad went. And you know what? Let's get to number 2. Alright guys, coming in number 2 is Blade Runner 2049. I really have fun watching this movie. That's all I gotta say about it. And the action scene is so awesome. The villain of this movie, played by Jared Leto, way better. He was in the Suicide Squad as a Joker. And Ryan Gosling is a really awesome character. My favorite character of this movie, it has to be the between with the Hilary Ford and that one girl. She was from No Time to Die and Knife Out. And so, yeah, and she was a Knock Knock. Yeah, I'm not talking about that piece of shit. Let's not talk about that. Don't you guys watch it. And so, yeah, guys, and here we go. And I know you ain't hitting Indiana Jones, but Indiana Jones, this has got to be one of the most dangerous production I ever seen next to Mission Impossible movie in No Time to Die 2. And so, yeah, guys, and that's why Blade Runner 2049 is at my number 2. Let's get to number 1, because these are my number 1 movie I really love the most, and I really want to rewatch the movie in the future. My number 1, my favorite rated R movie of all time, drum roll please. Last Night in the Soho. That's right, folks. My number 1 is Last Night in the Soho. One of the most terrifying movies I ever seen in my life. I have never seen this horror movie be so freaking awesome, man. Freaking awesome, because this movie is the whole element of really terrifying, but this has got to be one of the most scariest and the nightmare movies I ever been in my lifetime, because I'm probably this movie will get yourself in a nightmare, because I know with the Green Inferno. Now this, you're how you make a great rated R movie. Now this, you make a great horror movie. You gotta take a horror element, director. You gotta take a horror element. Just don't take element for your next and the Green Inferno. No, this is not how you make a horror movie. This is how you make a good horror movie. And I just do not get to hate with the ending, but the ending has got to be one of the most scariest ending of 2021 and I ever seen in my lifetime. in the villain of this movie. He was in Doctor Who. Don't get me wrong, I'm not a huge fan of Doctor Who. Doctor Who, the most overrated BBC shows I ever seen. Yeah, that's not my cup of tea. I will do a run of him in the future. And so, you guys, and that's why Last Night in the Soho is my number one favorite rated R movie of all time, and I cannot wait to rewatch this movie. I get it on DVD. So, you guys, that was my top 10 best rated R movie of all time. Tell me what you thought. Tell me what you read for your top 10 best rated R movie. And I know some of my audience for kids, but kids, just don't watch it, okay? Just don't watch it, because it's a rated R movie you're not supposed to watch. Because if you guys like Suicide Squad, if you like Logan, if you like Deadpool, if you like some action movie, if you like Joker, just don't watch this video. Just don't watch this video. So this video is really not for kids. So hey guys, if you watch this video, hit the subscribe button, notification, so it's funny. And I will do my top 10 worst rated R movie of all time today until tomorrow, because this is a happy video. And so hey guys, so stay tuned for my No Time to Die, the Zack Snyder Justice League teaser style. So yeah, and that's why, folks, I am officially going to do a No Time to Die trailer style. And so hey guys, I'll see you next time. So long, peace, YouTube. Thank you.